Very good day to one and all. Advances in cataract surgical techniques have reached its pinnacle today. Yet these scenarios continues to taunt us and corner us to delivering less than expected. Mature cataracts are still a common sight in our population. These few scenarios can happen to any of us despite our experience. Hence we, M&I Hospital, decided to show few case videos to encourage beginners to perform phaco in almost all difficult cataracts. Our incision decides our phaco. Two incision types can be used, first being the sclerocorneal tunnel incision. The wound integrity is better and conversion in case of a mishap is much easier. The other being a direct entry with a 2.2 or a 2.8 keratome is done by most senior surgeons. Capsule management is an essential step, as a successful capsular excess alone can help the surgeon perform phaco. Though femto lasers assures good rexus, its cost limits its usage. This video shows how inadequate staining of anterior lens capsule by the surgeon makes capsulorhexis difficult. As the intralenticular pressure is normal, absence of liquid cortex is present, so the surgeon is able to complete the rexis with a 26 gauge cystotome needle. Let's see a scenario of a mature cataract with liquid cortex. After initial nick with 26 gauge needle, the liquid cortex is washed and being removed with a Simco cannula. Then high density viscoelastic is injected into the bag and anterior chamber to provide support for completing the capsular excess. This is a case of mature cataract with increased intralenticular pressure. Liquid cortex is removed with BSS wash and anterior chamber filled with high density viscoelastic. Since the chance of runaway is high, a Utrata capsulorhexis forceps is being used with constant visco top up. Pull the capsule always towards the center. Here a case of a mature cataract with an elastic capsule in a young diabetic patient. In this case, the surgeon makes an initial rexus of about 3 mm, and once 270 degrees is completed, he expands it to a second rexus, or what we call a double rexus, of about 5 mm in diameter with constant visco top up, which helps to keep the anterior chamber formed and helps to prevent the rexus from running away. While extending, make sure that you always hold only the tip of the extended capsulorhexis, and the direction of the force should always be towards the centripetal. The posterior capsule is thin in mature cataracts, hence hydrodissection must be tailored to multiple small gentle injections of BSS with constant decompression of the nucleus. In case of a soft mature cataract with good zonular support and the parameter set right, the surgeon is performing a stop and chop technique. After trenching 2/3 of the depth, cracking is initiated. We need not wait to see the red glow, but make sure that the cracking happens complete. Then in phaco 2 mode, the nucleus is held and chopped into pieces and removed with a sharp chopper. The smaller the pieces, the better the nucleus removal will be easier. The hold of the nucleus should be at the posterior part of the nuclear core. If held anteriorly, the chances of nucleus losing its grip are more common. In this case of hard mature cataract, the modified direct chop technique comes into handy. In phaco 2 burst mode, with correct parameters and good AC stability, modified direct chop with a sharp long tip chopper is performed. The surgeon makes sure that the posterior plate cracks well before chopping into smaller pieces. The pieces can be removed as they are chopped, so this gives more surgical space for the nucleus to move. Most mature cataracts have little or no cortical matter. The bimanual cortex aspiration technique is the best suited as there is better control and anterior chamber stability. Once we have managed all the nuclear and cortical issues, the choice of IOL is for the surgeon to decide. It can either be a single piece foldable or a trifocal or a toric or even a multifocal, but make sure the viscoelastic under the lens is washed completely. Thank you from the team of MNI Hospital.